Hello, this is Bern, and on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you how to find out if the man that you're with, or the man who's into you, is marriage material or not. So stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great life to be.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams and attract the kind of quality man you want as a direct result of stepping into the most alive and the most feminine version of you. No need for gimmicks, manipulation, or stupid games. So here you go. I'm going to be sharing with you 9 specific ways of knowing if the man you're into is marriage material or not. First sign is a guy who is clear about what he wants in a woman. He's taking the time to think about what kind of woman he wants to be in, what kind of relationship he wants to be in, and as a result of that, he's able to have an intelligent conversation where he can share that with you without fretting, being worried, being anxious. He can just share it because he's been thinking about this and stepping into expressing what he wants into the world. Second one, which is similar to the first one, but has a nuance, which is he doesn't get scared when he gets asked, what are you looking for in a relationship? What are you looking for in a woman? The only man who's going to get scared by someone who says, well, I'm interested in marriage or I'm interested in children, is a guy who doesn't want any of those things. And if he doesn't want any of those things, then, and you do, you shouldn't be wasting your time with him, regardless of how cool, how cute he is, how awesome you think you might be together. If you're not compatible, it's a waste of your time, both of you. Third one, he has a reason for entering a relationship other than it feels good. Why? Because a relationship that stands the test of time, a marriage that lasts for many, many years, is going to take some feelings of responsibility, it's going to take sacrifice, it's going to take compromise, it's going to take doing things you don't want to do, being called into being of service to a woman. So if you're all about what feels good to me right now, well, it's not going to take too long before you're out of that equation if you're a guy. Number four, he has a vision for what he wants to do in his life and where he's heading beyond the day-to-day stuff. Why? Because if a guy is just living to the day, metaphorically speaking, paycheck to paycheck, but it's not even about the cash, he's just going with what happens every single day, the likelihood that you will feel safe in his sense of direction, the likelihood that you'll be able to relax into your feminine, the likelihood that he'll be able to be a leader in the relationship and drag things forward without you feeling like you have to carry your own weight and his, is going to be very, very small. So look for a man who has a clear vision for what he wants to accomplish and is doing something about it. It's not just like a dreamer, but he has a dreamer with a plan, and a dreamer with a plan and action to back it up. Next one is, he is a guy who knows how to move things forward. What does that mean? That means if he's interested in a relationship, he's interested in dating you, he's not waiting around for you to think about what it is that you want, or he's not waiting for you to call him up, he's not waiting for you to reach out to him, he's not waiting for you to move things forward. He will step into the leadership position of taking action and not have to wait for you to do what he's supposed to do. Next one is, he's not a guy who plays tricks or games. He's not into this petty thing of manipulation. He's not into this game of not just manipulating you, but he's not into this passive aggressive stuff. If he wants to say something, he says it. If he doesn't like something, he'll share it with you. If he likes something about you, he'll share it with you also. But he's not going to act in ways that leave you guessing and anxious and worried about what he's really thinking because he's acting weird. He's going to be direct, transparent, upfront, and tell you the way he thinks and feels, period. Next is, he has followed through on his promises. Why? And I'm talking about little things first, not just the big promises, but little things. If he says he's going to call you, does he call you? If he says he's going to get tickets for a thing, does he get tickets for a thing? I mean, like, you want to make sure that the guy that is going to promise you lifelong love has the ability to follow through on things that are simple. Why? If you can't follow through on things that are simple and easy, how on earth will you follow through on things that are challenging? Unlikely that it's going to happen. So make sure that the guy has the capacity to say something and stand in integrity and follow through an action to make sure that it takes place and it happens. Next one, I think it's number 8. So next one, number 8. He is a guy who can navigate disagreements respectfully with you. What does that mean? That means that there's going to be multiple times throughout your life with him where you and him are not going to see eye to eye on different subjects. It's okay to disagree. It's not cool to be disrespectful about it. So when he can get passionate without being disrespectful, that's someone that you can trust. If he can't tell you passionately what he wants, maybe he's not super strong in his intent of getting some things in life. But if he can share with you what he wants passionately, at the same time respecting your point of view, respecting that you're different, respecting that you have a different side to things that he hasn't fully grasped, doesn't make you wrong for it, it just makes you different, then that's totally cool as well. Last one, number 9, is he's a good friend. He has the capacity to develop a sense of friendship with you, loyal friendship with you. Why? Because the longest predictor of your sustainable relationship will not be how cool he is, how much chemistry there is between both of you. It's going to be the quality of your friendship. So he needs to be a guy who has the skills to build a friendship, to sustain a friendship, and to maintain his sense of upbeat understanding of what it really takes to walk side by side with someone beyond just the good times. Friends actually listen to each other. Friends go through sad times together. Friends stuck through thick and thin. And that's the kind of guy that you want. So hope this is helpful, insightful to you in some way. If it is, I'm going to ask you to do 3 things. Number 1, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number 2, subscribe to my channel and click the little bell if you want to be notified of new episodes as they come out. Number 3, and most important of all, if you want to take these concepts deeper and you want to understand how you can create the relationship you want and attract the kind of man you want, in a way that goes beyond this few minutes on this video, there's 2 things that I have for you. First one, on the first link on the description of this video, click on it, enter your name and email, and you'll be redirected to a free masterclass that I created for you. Second, if you want to work with me, there's a line on the description of this video, second line, that allows you to apply to see if we're fit to work together. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.